Hey guys, it's Dave here from Creative Path Films, and welcome to my giant whiteboard. Because today, we're gonna need it. In today's video, you're going to learn about the inverse square law and how it applies practically to both lighting for film and video, as well as audio recording. When you Google the inverse square law, this is what you're generally hit with. Math. Lots of math. So instead, I want to do my best to try and keep things as simple and as practical as I possibly can. The inverse square law is used to calculate the fall-off of a light source as you increase or decrease its distance away from your subject. If we have a light source and we have a subject, then that light source is going to put out a certain number of light rays that are going to hit that subject. Now, if we move our light source further away, those same light rays are spread over a much larger area, and therefore we have fewer light rays falling onto our subject. This is how light falloff works. Don't worry, there's a fairly simple equation that we can use to calculate the falloff based on how far away or how close we want to move our light. If you were to ask a mathematician, then they'd tell you that the intensity is inversely proportional to the square of the distance. Okay, so here's the formula. I for intensity equals 1 over d for distance squared. So let's assume that we want to double the distance of a light source. That's 1 meter away. So we want to take it 2 meters away. Now, because we're doubling the distance, d equals 2. So our equation is 1 over 2 squared, or 1/4. So doubling the distance, we get 1/4 the amount of light. Let's look at another example. If we want to triple the distance of our light source, then d becomes 3. So our equation is 1 over 3 squared, which is 1/9. So we have 1/9 the amount of light. All right, let's do one more to really cement this. Let's say we want to quadruple the distance of our light away from our subject. So d becomes 4. That means our equation is 1 over 4 squared, or 1/16, the original light intensity. So just from these few examples, you can see how quickly and dramatically light falls off as you move it further and further away from your subject. What if we want to move a light closer and not further away? Well, how do we work that out? Well, there's a fairly simple way to work that out as well. We just flip the equation around the other way. So let's say we want to halve the distance between the light and our subject, to take it from 1 meter to 0.5 meter. So let's apply that to our equation. The intensity equals 2 squared, or 4. So we have 4 times the amount of brightness than we had before. Here's another example. What if we want to move our light in to 1/3 of the original distance? Well, then the equation becomes intensity equals 3 squared, and we have 9 times the amount of output. Here's one final example. Let's say we want to close that distance into 1/4 the original distance. Well, then our equation becomes intensity equals 4 squared. So we have 16 times the original intensity. Now, this may seem confusing at first, but even if we can just get a handle on that rule of thumb of double the distance, quarter the amount of light, or halve the distance, 4 times the amount of light, just that ratio, then you'll have a really solid tool to help you when you need to quickly increase or decrease the amount of light falling on your subject. So let me give you a really practical example of where this has been really useful to me. I was shooting an interview for a client and they had this big tinted windows directly behind them. Now, although the tint was doing a lot of the work for me, it was still overpowering the amount of light falling on the subject. Now, I didn't have enough gels on hand to gel that window, and I had the light at 100% intensity, so I only had one option, and that was to move that light closer. So I took out my light meter and I did a reading of both the window and of the key light, and I found that the window was 4 times brighter than the intensity of my key. And because I knew that rule of thumb, I knew that I needed to bring that light in to half its original distance. Now, I couldn't quite do that just because of the limitations of the shot, but I got much closer to balancing those two out. This same rule also applies to audio recording as well. If you can halve the distance between your microphone and your subject, which is the source of the sound, then you're going to get 4 times the amount of audio signal, and then you can turn down your input gain and lower that noise floor, giving you a much, much cleaner recording. So get that microphone as close as you can, because the further away it is, you'll get exponentially more and more noise. Well, that's it for the inverse square law. I hope you found this video useful, and if you did, make sure to let me know by leaving it a thumbs up. And if you have any questions at all, please let me know down in the comments below. If you'd like to see more content just like this, make sure you subscribe to the channel. We put out new videos on a regular basis. Thanks for watching, guys, and we'll see you in the next one.